Phoenix and his question is there a way to create illustrations based on prompts that he's created or she's created with same characters in every scene? Any tips? Phoenix, my tip would be, if you open up Magic Media, so say you're working and you want to create these characters on Magic Media or Canva, you're going to open Magic Media and use your images. And with your images on Magic Media, you're going to type your prompt. But with creating characters that are similar in every scene, AI is not there to create 100% the way that they look in everything. We're not there yet. We're getting there, but we're not there yet. I've been trying this character with certain character reference that are very core. So things like short girl, skinny, round eyes, red hair, blue or green shirt, gray pants, white background, Pixar style. So the core things or the core character reference needs to be the same. And once you have that you've created, so you're gonna create how your character should look like. And what I've done, I went and I edited this prompt on Canva and I got different poses. So I asked the AI to give me a character where somebody's sitting down and sad, and give me a character where they are running. But the core fundamentals of the character are the same. That's why it gives me images of very similar person that I can use in a blog, in a book, in a character book or whatever it is, or video, that then I'll be able to use this character in different kinds of poses. The other way that you could do this, I went on ChatGPT and I added a prompt and I said to ChatGPT, help me with prompts that I can use to create illustrations based on my prompts with the same characters in every scene. My prompt is, and I told ChatGPT the core of what I want the character to look like. And then ChatGPT gave me 10 different poses that we can test together and see how it looks like. So let's start with the first one. ChatGPT said to us, let's create somebody that's arms crossed and looking determined. So I'm going to add the prompt on there, and it is on images, and I'm going to scroll down and generate. So this young lady looks very similar to this young lady that I keep on getting on the other images that I've created already. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add the image by clicking once and adding it to the list of images that I already have. And with Canva, you can click on the three dots or the nodes or the menu and ask Canva to generate more like this. So you want very similar to the image that they've generated for you, and Canva will give you similar images. And then you can look and see which one you want to use, which one is close. See, this one is cross-eyed. I don't like it, so I will use this one instead because it looks very similar to this one, but the eyes are much better than the one below. And when you scroll up, especially with her running over there and she's cross, and so you can use the generate more like this. And let's try a second prompt. We're gonna clear, we're gonna enter, and we'll generate again. This one looks very similar to that, and I can add it to my collection. My second last tip is, sometimes when you're creating these characters, the eyes color would be different, and that would be the image that you want to use. So with Canva AI, you're going to select the image, you're going to click on edit image, you're going to use the AI tools that we have on Canva. So with Magic Edit, you can select Magic Edit and you can brush over whatever you want to change. So I'm going to reduce the size and I'm going to select the eyes, and I'm going to ask AI to change the color for me so that it's consistent with the other images. And I click on generate. And I pick any of these and I'm going to click on done. And my image is exactly what I want. So you've been creating these characters in a blank background, or it doesn't matter even if it has some sort of a background. Use your Canva to take off the background on a image and then add your own scenes. So say for example, she's a running girl and we want to add like a running scene that we get from Canva. So we can create a running scene, replace it as a background and add the person on the scene. And we are creating our own story this way, but with the character that we want. When you are asking the tool to create both the scene as well as the character, it might be confusing. So you're making it simpler for the tool. You can either create the scene on its own and the character on its own and then combine the two, or you could go to Canva's element and look for the scenes and combine them so that you have exactly what you want. Okay, Phoenix, let me know if this has helped you or anybody else. Let me know in the comments below if videos like this are assisting you. I have created an AI prompts video that you could go watch. Thank you so much for joining me today. I will see you with our next video.